Good morning. Dear graduates, parents, and esteemed guests, it is my absolute joy and privilege to stand before you today to celebrate the achievements of the graduating class of 2024. It has been an honor to serve as your eighth grade math teacher and also as your eighth grade advisor. Today is a proud moment for me as I take part in your award ceremony this morning and watch later as you receive your diplomas. My hope is that you keep listening to that inner voice that's telling you how to stay true to what you know is right. Think about who you are and what you want for your future, and make sure that the choices you make are keeping you right on that path. I want to share two pieces of advice as you leave KCS and start your next 4 years of school. One, try everything. Yes, I mean everything. Try everything in sports, everything in school, every educational, extracurricular, athletic opportunity. Each of you have a talent or gift, and if you don't try new things, you might miss the chance to discover what they might be. Next, be kind. But let me be clear. I know kindness is not always easy. It requires courage, empathy, and a willingness to set aside judgment and assumptions. Kindness means extending a hand to someone who is struggling, offering a kind word to someone in need, and standing up for those who shouldn't have to stand up for themselves. Hopefully, you will remember hearing this every day, as Mr. Flynn always stated at the end of every morning announcement, "Be kind, Red Raiders." Next, I want to give a special thanks to the business in our community. McDonough's, Italian Touch, Nemo's, Uncle Louie's, they are always willing to help support our students. And then our eighth grade parents, where would I be without you? Your dedication and hard work, we were able to make the year-end activities the best they could be. I would like to personally thank Mrs. Greenberg, Mrs. Tevis, Mrs. Powers, Mrs. O'Rourke, Mrs. McKay, Mrs. Galley, Mrs. Smith, and the list can go on and on. There's so many of you that have gone above and beyond with fundraisers, work in the snack stand, donations, volunteering to help with the dance and scavenger hunt. Please, let's give your parents a round of applause. In conclusion, as we celebrate the award recipients, we are in fact celebrating as a community. For the achievements of our young people here today are not merely their own, but also due to the efforts and encouragement of parents, teachers, school leaders, and the Keyport community. And I thank all of you for your strong support and partnership, which have enabled our students to flourish and achieve their potential in the different pathways in education. Students, please continue to grow in the qualities that will enable you to make a positive impact to others in life. While we live in a world that is constantly changing, remain steadfast in the values that ground our community. Find joy in learning and continue to pursue your dreams. Use your knowledge, talents, and skills to be true to yourself and others. Imagine what the world could be if each of you do this. Congratulations to all our recipients, and I wish you all the very best. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Diley. If you are going to receive an award, you're coming up on this side and you'll exit this side, okay? Now I'd like to bring to the stage Melissa Vecchio to present the Recreation Award and the Mayor's Award.
Hi, everybody, and congratulations. The mayor couldn't be here, but I was honored when she asked me if I would come and present these two awards for her. First, for the mayor's award, the recipient is Lila Henn. And for the Recreation Award, Megan Francis.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Ms. Vecchio. I now invite Kathleen McNamara to the stage to present the Democratic Club Award.
So good morning, graduates, and good morning to all of the members of each of your students' teams. These teams include parents, families, friends, motivators, mentors, and educators, and today represents a page turner in so many lives. But before we move along, today also represents a day to take moments and reflect on the journey here. I'm here today as a representative of the Keyport Democratic Club to acknowledge and recognize a student who has demonstrated outstanding service and has positively impacted her peers here at Keyport Central School and within the community. Some things to know about her: she's in Girl Scouts, bridging to senior this year. She's volunteered at the school and the library as a member of the National Junior Honor Society, and the class salutatorian is heading on to biotech in September. Hannah Kelsey, thank you for your volunteerism. And we wish you miles of smiles and success as you continue into the next chapter.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. McNamara. At this time, I'd like to call up Tina Wright to present the Percy and Gwendolyn Washington Memorial Scholarship.
Good morning, everyone. You can do better than that. You're graduating. Good morning.
Good morning.
There we go. I'm delighted to be here this morning with you on your special day. Congratulations, KCS Class of 2024. I am Tina Wright, the proud parent of Christopher Wright, alum class of 2015. He would have been here today to share your special day. However, he graduated from George Washington University last year and just started his job this year, and he had a meeting and they wouldn't allow him to attend. I just want to share a little bit about the award that I'm presenting this morning. It started out as the Percy Washington Memorial Scholarship. Mrs. Washington lost her husband, and she wanted to do something special and wanted his legacy to live on. So she was presenting an award annually to the high school students on behalf of the Keyport Civic League. So she said, I'm going to do something a little different. I'm going to give it to a KCS student. So she reached out to the school and asked, she said, you know, I don't want any essays because they're going to be bombarded from here on out with essays. So I'm just going to ask the school for the individual, an African-American student with the highest GPA. Unfortunately, 7 months later, Mrs. Washington passed away. So Christopher didn't want to be the only recipient of the award, so he, with the permission of her family, asked if he can continue in honoring both of their legacy. Let me just give you a little history on Mr. and Mrs. Washington. They were lifelong residents and pillar of the community here in Keyport. Mrs. Washington, she was very active in Keyport Second Baptist Church, Keyport Senior Center, also the Civic League. Mr. Washington, he was a proud member of the Keyport Kiwanis for over 70 years. He served on different boards throughout the community of different banks, Bayshore Community Hospital. But one good thing about that Mr. Washington was very proud of, he was the owner and operator of Washington Auto Sales right here in Keyport, New Jersey, and it was located where the Board of Education is, and he did that for 50 years. He was the first African American to own and operate a Nissan franchise. So who would have thought that little boy from this little town in Keyport, New Jersey, would go on and later operate a franchise, first Nissan franchise for 50 years. So KCS students, nothing is out of your reach. So remember that as you journey on, the next 4 years, you lay your foundation, think of something you're passionate about. And if you don't have nothing you're passionate about right now, don't worry, because your passion may find you. And what I mean by that is, have you ever tried something and you was like, I really don't like it, or I don't want to do it, and it turns out, hey, that was pretty cool. And on top of that, I'm good at it. So just remember that as you journey on to your next 4 years, over and transition over to high school, all things are possible. If you be it, steadfast, and you see it and you believe it, you can achieve it, okay? Let me get back to my script, because I went off script there. I don't know how that happened. So on behalf of my son, Christopher Wright, I'm honored to present this award. Now it's going to be the Percy and Gwendolyn Washington Memorial Scholarship, because they both have passed on, to the highest GPA African-American student in the class of 2024. So it is with great pleasure and honor that I pronounce this year's recipient, Bishop Rothwell. I just want to share with you, because it was Mr. Flynn give you these words. He said, Mom, I want you to do three things, and don't tell him I didn't do it. He said, be kind, be brief, and be seated. So don't tell him I went off script here.
Thank you so much, young man. Congratulations.
Ms. Wright, you can go off script anytime. Those were powerful words. Thank you very much. Now, I would like to bring to the stage John Merla to present the Republican Club Award. And Joe Merla.
I was set up following Tina's powerful speech. Very great, gracious words. Well, good morning, everyone, and it's a pleasure to be here on behalf of the Keyport Republican Organization. I'm John Merla. I am the chairman of the Republican Organization of Keyport. With me to my left is my brother Joe, who's a Republican Council candidate for Borough Council. I want to thank you, and I want to congratulate you at the same time. Thank you for taking these past 10 years very seriously in Keyport Grammar School, and look forward to your years at high school. Hard work pays off. No matter what kind of work you do in life, hard work pays off. And high school, you will find, is going to be the best years of your life, so cherish them every moment that you can. 44 years ago, I walked across that high school field, and I received one award, and that award still sticks with me till today. Most school spirit. I loved getting that award. I could have probably gotten more, but that was the award that stuck with me for my life, because it proved that you could do anything you want to do for the community that you love and you live in. And that's what you're doing right now. You're living your lives. In order to get where you want to go in life, you must always remember where you came from. And that's what you're going to learn in life, that you've come from a good town, you have great parents, good educators, good staff. Love your school, love your town, love your parents most importantly, and love your family, and you'll be successful in life. And I applaud each and every one of you. Each and every one of you in our hearts are awarded today, because you'll be rewarded with a diploma. And that you should be gracious. And please, always remember, give thanks to the parents. Give thanks to your parents and grandparents and guardians, because they're the ones that are behind you at all times. When things are down, you could always look forward to a good parent to talk to, and your educators. Today, we're going to give two awards out, and these awards go to individuals that go above and beyond, not only with community spirit, but community service. So our first award is for Annabella Yao. Congratulations. Congratulations. The second award goes to an individual that I've known a long time, and you always see him in town, always respectful, always has his helmet on when most of his friends don't. And yes, they know. Huh? And just a good kid that comes from a good family. And it gives us a great pleasure to award this to Robert Greenberg. Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Joe and John. Excellent job. At this time, I'd like to welcome Gail Bechtold to present the Cherry Hill Community Service Award.
Good morning. Congratulations. I graduated from Keyport Grammar School, which is now 7-Eleven, in 1964, 60 years ago. So I just want to give you a little background on Cherry Hill. She taught 41 years, second grade. She used to love to tell everybody that. She was a student in the second grade because she learned as much from her students as they did from her. And every day, she would have lunch bunch for kids that just couldn't get their work done or they didn't understand it. So she built a bond with them. But one of the most impressive things that she did was start Potholders or Us. And every child in her classroom had a position, whether it was requisitions, buying the potholder loops, or whether it was distribution, putting them in the plastic bags. But her deal was that these kids build their self-esteem, and that they learn some economics, and that they learn how to raise money for children with cancer. And in her years, she gave tens of thousands of dollars with her students to the Sunshine House down in Long Branch for children with cancer. And every year, they would have an assembly here at night, and every single child in her room, no matter how shy they were, would get up and speak. It was a great thing. Out in front of this building, there was a sign hung over the door, a big banner that said best practices for the state of New Jersey. They invited Miss Hill to go down to Trenton for the Teachers Association, and she explained to all of them how she made this happen, how she fostered the children, how much they enjoyed it, and the lessons that they learned. Over the years, Sherry was a member of Juvenile Conference Committee, which was a program for first offenders under the age of 18. And the goal was to teach them good things to do with their lives and turn their lives around from some stupid mistake that they had made. She was a part of the Keyport Kiwanis for over 30 years. She was part of the Jersey Shore Work Camp that built houses for people that couldn't afford them. She was part of the Food Ministerium that started out at St. Mark's as a tiny little building giving out 10, 15 bags a week to the ministerium that is now over here by the community church in Keyport. She was also part of the Bayshore Meals. We used to go to New York on Friday nights and give out food and clothing. One year I gave away her brand new coat, but she forgave me. I want to thank you so much for this opportunity to share Sherry's story. This is the first time that this award is being given out. She became ill last fall and passed away in March. It was unexpected, but she loved children, and she wanted to see them be the best person they could possibly be, no matter what their ability was. So go out there, embrace the world, take every opportunity you can, learn how to grow from it, listen to people, discern what they say, but form your own opinions. So God bless you all. And I would like to present this award to a very deserving student, Teresa Smith. Thank you so much. God bless.
Thank you, Ms. Beckel. Now, I'd like to bring up our PTO president, Mrs. Greenberg, to present the PTO awards.
Good morning. For those of you that don't know me, I'm Christina Greenberg, your PTO president. Good morning, class of 2024. So when you guys were in PTO, when you guys were in pre-K, that is when I joined the PTO. And the year you guys went into kindergarten, I became PTO president. So we have done this together. I could not be prouder of each and every one of you. I have watched you all blossom into beautiful young adults, and I am so proud of you. Robert made a bet with Darren last night that I wasn't going to cry, so I'm going to try really hard to prove him wrong this morning. So our first two awards are for Safety Patrol. Can Aiden Nagy please come up? Gabriella Jordan, please come up. Our next award is for Excellent in Music. Can Penelope Yang please come up? So the next awards are picked by the PTO personally. It is our School Spirit Award. This award goes to students that we feel over the years have really demonstrated pride in being a part of Keyport and are looking forward to being involved, give back to their community. So the first, there's always girls and boys. The first is a young girl that is involved often. At games, she shows up, whether she is playing whatever sport we're at or she shows up in the stands. I think she probably yells Robert James louder than I do. Jaden Lakowick, will you please come up? Now, when it came to the boys, you guys probably all thought that Robert would have won hands down. But we really could not pick, because I have to say there are four boys that in particular that have played in every sport I could think of, support their classmates, volunteer. Robert, I haven't lost it yet. So I'm gonna call them up each individually and ask them to stand to take a group picture, which they all expect out of me at this point. Aiden Nagy, please come up. Stand right here. Sean Canallen, please come up. Wayne Powers, please come up. Robert, I want to let you know that while I made the slideshow, there is a photo of you and your sister, and you are in kindergarten helping mommy set up for a PTO event. So I want to personally thank you for constantly giving back, dealing with every picture. I'm going to keep it together. Dealing with every picture mommy has taken and being a beaming example of who I always thought you would be. Please come up to get your award.
Great job, guys. Thank you, Ms. Greenberg. Now, I'd like to turn it over to Ms. Maganelli, who will present our Keyport Education Association Awards.
Good morning. It's my honor to announce the Keyport Education Association 8th Grade Awards this morning. Our first award is the Bobby Thompson Math Award. Mrs. Thompson was a beloved central school teacher for many years. While she taught multiple grades, math was always her passion. The recipient of the Bobby Thompson Award for Excellence in Mathematics demonstrates critical thinking outside of the box. She has the outstanding ability to think logically and deductively. This student goes above and beyond to take ownership of her education and continuously challenges herself. She strives to not only understand and apply mathematical concepts in the classroom, but also understands how her learning will impact her future. This award goes to Abby Kutakowski. Congratulations. The Language Arts Award. The recipient of the Language Arts Award demonstrates excellence in reading and writing, as well as leadership and respect in discussion and participation. This student goes above and beyond to take ownership of his education and continuously challenges himself to be the best critical reader and writer he can be. He is inclusive of his peers and goes out of his way to ensure everyone's voice is heard. A natural discussion leader, he strives to extend his thinking and evaluate how the ideas of others can impact his own ideas. A desire to learn and an enthusiastic effort to succeed is present in his daily life in and outside of the classroom. The Language Arts Award goes to Lorenzo Johnson. The Excellence in Science Award. The recipient of the Science Award demonstrates excellence in her ability to think analytically and critically about various scientific phenomena in order to solve real-life problems. This student must be able to adequately research and demonstrate scientific principles and laws in order to evaluate evidence and draw conclusions from data gathered through scientific inquiry. Throughout this year, she has exceeded expectations in all of these areas and has demonstrated her ability beyond a reasonable doubt to utilize these skills in all aspects of her classwork. The Science Award goes to Hannah Kelsey. Congratulations. The Janet Strid Social Studies Award. The recipient of the Social Studies Award demonstrates the understanding of the fundamental principles and values of American democracy. This student appreciates the global dynamics between people, places, and resources. She shows high interest in learning about different cultures and civilizations all over the world. The Social Studies Award goes to Kira Egan. Congratulations. Most improved all around. This will be awarded to two recipients. Through this academic year, the recipients of this award have shown the most significant growth all around in work ethic, behavior, and responsibility this year. They have demonstrated an increased desire to learn and grow. They have taken responsibility for their education and shown interest in continuing to grow as a young adult. They sought out assistance when needed and readily accepted that assistance. When applying themselves in their work, they show a tremendous amount of potential and dedication. The Most Improved All-Around Award goes to Stephanie Gonzalez-Torres and Heriberto Mariano. The Charlotte Sustersick Sportsmanship Award. Miss S was a gym teacher at Central School for decades. Her gregarious personality and enthusiasm have endeared her to former students and staff alike. The Charlotte Sustersick Sportsmanship Award goes to John Avito. Congratulations. The Louise Elvinger Art Award. Mrs. Elvinger taught art at Central School for many years. Her passion for art and art history inspired a plethora of students to pursue their creative dreams. The Louise Elvinger Art Award for overall achievement in art is awarded to Gabriella Johnson. Gabriella Jordan. Congratulations. The Sandy Crook Award. This will go to two recipients. Ms. Crook grew up in Keyport and was a physical education teacher. The Sandy Crook Outstanding Student in Health and Physical Education Award goes to Nicholas Rowald and Sophia Bronstein. Congratulations. Congratulations. The Connie Costantino Award. Mrs. Costantino was an integral part of the child study team as a social worker. Her kind, selfless manner was truly a gift to many of the lives she impacted. The Connie Costantino Award for overall outstanding achievement is Kenya Juarez. The Fritz Guzman Most Improved Writing Award. The Fritz Guzman Award is presented to a student who has shown determination and growth in the area of writing throughout the year. This student has persevered to strengthen their writing, collaborate with their peers and teachers, and try new strategies in their writing. For this person, writing comes naturally, but they still work hard to learn and grow in writing. The Fritz Guzman Most Improved Writing Award is awarded to Charlotte McKay. The next award is the Keyport Food Ministerium Award. This is a new award this year. Natalie couldn't be here this morning, but I know she's extremely proud of the relationship that we've built between the Central School and the Keyport Food Ministerium Food Pantry, and we're thrilled that we had the opportunity to go and spend so much time with her. The recipient of this award, and this will also go to two recipients as well. The recipient of this award is given to two students who demonstrate exceptional commitment and dedication in helping their local food pantry. This award highlights the students' volunteer efforts, including assisting with the distribution of food, volunteering on their own time, and showing leadership in service activities. The award goes to Megan Francis and Robert Greenberg. Our final award is Excellence in Attendance. The Perfect Attendance Award is granted to those students who have maintained perfect attendance throughout the academic year. The award goes to Michelle Mata and Aris Cruz Cortez. Congratulations to all of our honorees.
Thank you, Ms. Manganelli. Okay, this is my favorite part. As we conclude the award ceremony, I want to express how proud I am of this eighth grade class. Your hard work has been inspiring. It has been a pleasure to watch you grow from pre-K all the way through eighth grade, and I'm confident in your ability to succeed in wherever you go next. Congratulations to each and every one of you. And at this time, we will present a video.
This moment in the back of my mind, the time we stood with our shaking hands, the crowds in stands went wild. We were the kings and the queens, and they read off our names. The night you danced like you knew lives would never be the same. You held your head like a hero on a history book page. It was the end of a decade, but the start of an age. Long live. Remember this feeling, I passed the pictures around of all the years that we stood there on the sidelines wishing for right now. We are the kings and the queens. You traded your baseball cap for a crown when they gave us our trophy. This is absurd. promise me this, that you'll stand by me forever. But if God forbid fate should step in and force us into a goodbye, if you have children someday, when they point to the picture, the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything,
Miss Greenberg, did you cry?
I did not cry.
Wow. Wow. That was tough to watch. Before we move on, and this is just one piece of today, we have so much offered for these guys today. I want to thank the presenters. You guys made that special. Thank you for coming here today. Great job for the presenters. For Miss Diley and Miss Maganelli, Miss Pearson, Miss Apruzzi, Miss Buttacavoli, all staff members, Dr. Savoia is here, and she will speak with you later at 5 p.m. I also want to recognize board members that are here. Thank you for coming to join us today. And for you guys, the day is fun-filled. We will have a few minutes for some pictures over here by our backdrop, but just a few, because we do have to move on to other things. It's a busy day.